Next, we have poster 72, Shortage of Public Health Midwives in Sri Lanka. The authors are De Silva MDK, Thalagala NI, Karthikeyan P, and Rubasinghe MS. The presenting author is Karthikeyan P.
Good afternoon, Chair and panel of judges and the audience. This is regarding the shortage of midwives in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is well known in the international arena for the performing public health sector well, and the pillars are the public health midwives in our country. There are concerns that now, due to various reasons, increasing NCD and growing aging population, our midwives are adding more workload, but there is a gap in the knowledge. We don't know what is the actual workload of the midwives and what is our need, the staff need for the midwives in the Sri Lanka. So we did the scientific method. This is the first time in Sri Lanka. We conducted this according to the vision, that is a WHO recommended tool to analyze the workload indicated based staff need in the Sri Lanka. And this is conducting the three phases. First, we analyze the task, and then we analyze the workload. For that also, we use the software recommended by the WHO. It's called One Health Tool. And then finally, we analyze the staff need. And this is, we used a multi-stage random cluster sampling. The finding was, we need for the Sri Lanka 11,612 midwives, but currently we have only 7,087 midwives. And the gap is 4,525 midwives. At the same time, currently we are using the ratio for 3,000 population, one midwife. But the study shows that scientifically, one PHM can look after only 1,878 population. Therefore, we recommend to train at least 1,000 midwives per year in Sri Lanka. Thank you.
The post is open for discussion.
Now, when you use the One Health tool, in the stakeholder workshops, was there anything that was different to the, you know, recommended ways of calculating using the tool? Was there any differences that you saw in the requirements when you did the stakeholder workshops?
Yeah, in One Health tool, what we do is, we actually analyze the workload. It differ, because in Colombo, in Kandy, in North and East, Tehran, the space, and these limitations are there. So we use the time motion study to calculate how many minutes are taking for one task, and we are grouping this task. When we load this information, the One Health tool will give the specifically the midwife to perform this particular task, average how many minutes needed.
And you use the stakeholder workshops to come?
Yes.
To come.
We use that, there are 277 PHMs we studied.
Right.
And actually that now we are only training for 400. Our capacity is in now 9 province, we have a training centers. We can train 800, but currently we are only training 400, average 400 midwifery students per year. The course is 18 months. So that is a setback we are having. We need to increase it.
Why did you go only by the population without going for population density?
Yeah, that is studied in the One Health tool. The density, Tehran, everything included in that.
Yes.
So after that only we loaded that information to the work indicator. These are the scientific methods, the softwares. Then it applied to the population. It divided into the population to get the country average.
So basically what you say is that when you arrive at that per population, the number, you have already taken the density into account.
Yes.
Thank you once again. Please give a round of applause.